On 17 September 1939, the Red Army crossed the Polish frontiers. Acting in close coordination with Wehrmacht, it seized 119,000 square kilometers of territory with population of more than 12 million people. By the end of September, more than 240,000 Polish soldiers were prisoner of war, POWs, and 126,000 of them were transported to the USSR. On 19 September, Beria signed order establishing a USSR NKVD directorate for a phase of POW, the POW for short. The new entity was led by Sapronenko. The NKVD had established 8 camps for 10,000 inmates each. However, the camps and assembly points were unable to house and feed the prisoners or even to provide them with water. On 3rd October, a Politburo Central Committee Communist Party made a decision to release 42,000 soldiers and junior ranks of the Polish army who lived on the annexed territory. Shortly after, the USSR and Germany reached an agreement on the exchange of Polish POWs. As a result, the Soviet Union received about 14,000 non-commissioned officers and soldiers and handed 42,500 over to the Germans. Subsequently, by 1st November 1939, 3 special camps had been established, including 2 for 8,500 officers in Kozelsk and Starobelsk, and 1 in Ostashkov for 6,500 policemen, gendarmes, and bodyguards. 4 labor camps were set up for 25,000 POWs. A total of 407,000 people were arrested in Western Ukraine and Western Belarus between September 1939 and 1st December 1940. In November, several high-ranking officers of the central apparatus of the NKVD were assigned to the Kozelsk, Starobelsk, and Ostashkov camps to conduct an investigation. As a result, the Stalinist authority received full information on Polish officers and policemen. It was clear that the Polish prisoners did not accept the four-way partition of Poland, and they were ready to fight for independence. On 1st December 1939, Beria sent a special investigation team of the NKVD State Security Department, headed Belalipitsky, at Ostashkov camp. At the end of January 1940, it had to prepare all the Ostashkov cases for presentation to the NKVD Особое совещание, Special Commission, Russian abbreviation OSO. On December 31, Beria issued a serious order directed at the ending of the investigation in late January and dispatching additional teams of agents to Ostashkov, Kozelsk, and Starobelsk for that purpose. The head of the depot, Sapronenko, was ordered to go in person to Ostashkov and to take all measures to complete by the end of the January the preparation of all policemen cases for report to OSO. Though preparation the cases of officers from Kozelsk and Starobelsk for submission to the Special Commission was not preplanned. On 1st February 1940, around 6,000 cases assigned to the OSO. Toward the end of the same month, the OSO delivered its sentences on 600 policemen. Its sentences to defendants from 3 to 8 years of labor in camp of Kamchatka and Nozerest camp. Army officers not interrogated by OSO. On 20 February, Sapronenko submitted his proposals on clearing out Starobelsk and Kozelsk camp to Beria. He wrote, "I request your permission to draw up cases against the officers of the COP, personnel of law courts, and prosecutor officers, landowners, activists of POW and Strelets parties, officers of the second department of the former Polish general staff, and intelligence officers, about 400 men, for examination by special commission under NKVD. Also, the document bears the handwriting note, Comrade Merkulov discussed this with me, Beria, 20 February. As a result, USSR Deputy People Commissars of Internal Affairs Merkulov issued a special directive on 22 February concerning the posts listed above. It ordered their transfer to the prison of Regional NKVD Administration, or NKVD for short. The special commission about which Sopronenko wrote to Beria did not figure in Merkulov directive. This indicates that Beria had not yet made final decision as to which body would investigate the cases of Poles who were being transferred to jails. It seems that he decided to discuss with Stalin the measures to be taken in regarding the Polish post officer and police. The choice of body to investigate these cases depend on that decision. The special commission had no authority to sentence people to be shot. It is clear from NKVD documents that after February 20, Beria suspended examining of cases post police by special commission and their sending to Kamchatka. On 27 February, Beria met Stalin, and it is evident that it was at that meeting that the decision to shoot off posts from three special camps was taken. The first variant of his paper to Stalin was written on February 29. The final variant of Beria writing to Stalin was compiled on March 3rd. The shooting of 14,700 posts from the three camps and 11,000 prisoners jailed in western province of Ukraine and Belarus was proposed in it. The examination of cases and carrying out of the decision had to a troika, three-personal tribunal, consisting of the Merkulov, Kabulov, and Bashtakov. On 5th March, Beria proposals was approved by Politburo. What were the reason for this decision? Stalin was picked the defeat in 1920 and must have felt a particular dislike for Polish army commanders. Having recognized the liquidation of Polish state, he clearly wanted to rid himself of those who might subsequently join a struggle for the renewal of their country. Expulsion of the USSR on 14th December 1939 from League of Nations at the urging of England, France, and Polish government immensely increased anti-West, anti-Polish outlooks of Stalin. After adoption of the decision by the Supreme Allied Council to send expeditionary force to Finland, Polish government began striving for including them in military detachment. On 24th January 1940, Sikorsky declared on a council of minister minutes that sending expeditionary force to Finland would involve France and Great Britain into de facto war with Russia that is very desirable for Poles. The Soviet ambassador in Great Britain, Maisky, informed Moscow that in British and French government, the tendency for involvement into Soviet-Finnish conflict seriously strengthened, that they were ready to act without stopping before the risk to cancel relation and even armed conflict. Even after 12th March 1940, when peace treaty with Finland had been concluded, a war with Western power was still taken into consideration by the USSR leadership planning to annex Baltic country. In February-March 1940, the plans of bombardment oil fields of Baku in Caucasus were being actively elaborated in France and Great Britain.